All right, guys, back at Sonoma Raceway. First time with the Integra Type S in non-stock form. Let's see how it does here.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Oh man.
Nice save, man.
Yeah, that
holy
was...
shit. That was wild.
Alright guys, day two here at Sonoma Raceway with light speed. This will be my first session of the day. It's already 77 degrees Fahrenheit. Basically, I'll get maybe one or two laps of warm-up and then I'll have my chance at a PB. Goal is sub 150. Full list of mods in the video description. The Öhlins Road and Track, which is a pre-production version. I chose my own spring rate, 7 kg front, 10 in the rear. The production version of the Öhlins Road and Track is not yet available for the DE5 or FL5. All right, let's see if we can pull it off.
Track out.
couldn't quite do it, 150.21, and that's with me completely blowing the last corner. I braked way too late, missed the apex, fought massive understeer in third gear going onto the main straight. I think if I nailed that corner, it'd be an easy 49. I mean, just look at the optimal, 49.54. Just wasn't able to string it all together in the first session. But the car rotates beautifully on turn-in now if I trail brake. It's not going to happen today. It's a little bit too warm out now. My engine is starting to creep up in temp after only about 5 laps. Basically, my best shot was in the morning, so we'll have to wait till next time to see if we can break sub 150. The car can easily do it, no problem. I'm sure of that. And on top of that, the car subjectively feels so much better to drive now because of the higher spring rates, especially the rear spring rate. I can really trail brake the car into the corner, get the rear to step out to avoid turn-in understeer. I still do have a bit of mid-corner understeer and definitely on corner exit, it's just an exercise in patience, but I don't know if there's any way around that for a front-wheel drive vehicle. Anyways, until next time, we'll track this car again. I'm not planning to make any setup changes. I think at this point, other than the overheating, it's really all about just getting as much seat time as possible because the car finally handles how I want it to for the most part. Now it's just a matter of whether I can deliver. All right, thank you guys for watching. Another shout out to Lightspeed. See you in the next one.